You know what I love? I love that I filmed this entire video already. And I was out of focus for the whole fucking thing.
I'm a dumbass.
Today's video is going to be my second attempt at filming the anti-TBR tag, which is basically me telling you about all of your faves that I don't care to read. So let us just get straight into the questions. This was created by Nicole and her books. I will leave her channel linked in the cards and in the description down below. The first question is a popular book everyone loves that you just don't care to read. And for this one, I'm going to have to go with everybody's favorite. Y'all won't shut up about this book. Daisy Jones and the Six by Taylor Jenkins Reid. Oh my goodness, I have never seen a community go hard for a book until this. First it was Seven Husbands of Evelyn Hugo. Like, y'all were going crazy for that. And then when this came out, I am interested in reading Evelyn Hugo. She also has another book called Maybe in Another Life that I find interesting as well. This one, however, I just... First of all, I don't like music. Like, I mean, I like music, but I don't like music facts. I don't like the history of the music industry. I don't like to learn about those things. I find those things to be very boring. I heard that this is told in interview format, which... I know people are going to say, well, Saajid, you don't have to like those things in order to enjoy this story. You don't, you know, you could listen to the audiobook because the audiobook is really good. Like, I understand all of that. And I'm not saying that I wouldn't enjoy this book if I read it. Obviously, I have preconceived notions that mightn't actually represent what this story is about. But I just have literally no inclination to read this whatsoever. If I do read it, it would be because I read other books by Taylor Jenkins Reid and I enjoyed those. So I finally decided to give this a chance. But even after I read the two books that I'm interested in, I still don't know if I will be interested in this one. So sorry if this is your fave, but like, I just don't really care to read it. Question number two is a classic book or author that you have no interest in reading. For me, it's going to have to be Catcher and the Rye by J.D. Salamander. What's her name again? Anyways, I don't care to read her. I'm sure she's a good book. Everybody talks about how much they like this book. I just have literally no desire to read it whatsoever. I don't even know what it's about. I just look at the cover and I'm like, ugh, you know? Number three is a popular author that you have no interest in reading. And number 3.2 is a popular author who's problematic that you have no interest in reading. So for this one, I'm going to go with Stephen King. I know some people find him problematic for various reasons. I haven't really looked too much into that and I don't really care either. I just don't really care to read his books, whether he's problematic or not. I am not really interested in horror. I'm not really interested in thrillers or anything of that sort. So I'm just not really inclined to read Stephen King. His books just, I don't know, like if I do read horror, if I do get into more of that kind of dark literature, I want it to be, you know, books like, you know, from authors of color, from, you know, the kind of authors that I generally tend to be more interested in, as opposed to, you know, an old white man. I do have a fun story that will probably make y'all unsubscribe to me, however. When I was in secondary school, I won an award, and this is when I was a teenager, before I got into reading. I used to hate reading. Before I was 17, I hated reading, and I won an award for doing good in a subject, and I think the award was like the Stephen King books. I think it was called Different Seasons, and it was like a, it was like multiple books in one, so it was like a bind up. So it was like this really thick mass market paperback, and I was like, I ain't gonna read this shit, so I hollowed it out, and I used to put things in it. It was really fun, but and every time I tell somebody that, especially a book lover, they just like want to die and strangle me, so. Number four is an author that you've read a couple books from, but you will not read anything else from them. There's one author in mine who I've read 7 books from her. Sorry, I had something. There was a bug on my shelf. I just had to like clear it out. Obviously, I will not be reading anything else that J.K. Rowling writes. I read the Harry Potter series. I love it for what it is. Will I be rereading it anytime soon? Probably not, but I still have the books. And what I will never ever do, even if she writes something Harry Potter related, I will never read anything else that J.K. Rowling publishes. I don't like that woman anymore for obvious reasons, for her disgusting politics and her views on trans women and her essentialist perspective on gender. Like, I just can't fuck with that shit in 2020. But what I also don't like about J.K. Rowling is her attitude and her behavior. The way that she plays victim, the way that she thinks that she's the victim of cancel culture, like, bitch, you's a freaking multimillionaire. Ain't nobody canceling you even if they wanted to. Anyway, Anyways, let me not talk about J.K. Rowling because I'll just start to get angry. I don't like her. I'm not going to read anything else she publishes in the future. She could suck on a Horcrux for all the fucks I have to give. Period! The next one is a genre that you have no interest in reading. And as you all know, I don't read a lot of genres. I only read like YA contemporary and adult literary fiction and the odd like what sci-fi book can be. But if there's one genre that I just don't really care to read that much, it will have to be romance. And it's not because I'm one of those people who's like, oh, romance is bad, it's terribly written, it's shallow, it's this, it's that. I just have no interest in the romance books that I see. I don't like the surface level of it. I don't like the covers, the new cartoony covers. I don't like them. I never like the old, you know, guy with abs on the covers either. Like, I just don't care for romance or erotica or anything like that. Like, if I'm in the mood, I could read like a little erotic novella or something like that, but I just don't see myself reading a full-length romance novels. Like, they just don't appeal to me. The next one is a book that you've bought which you might never read. So I read the Hunger Games series back in 2014 and I really liked it, but I hated the editions that I had. I had the original editions, plus they didn't match. The first two were paperbacks and the last one was hardcover and it was a used book, so it was kind of beat up. So I didn't like them, so I got rid of them, and I always thought to myself like I'd repurchase the Hunger Games series one day, and I did recently. But I don't know if I'll reread it. Like, I just don't care to reread The Hunger Games. It's one of those things like Harry Potter. Like, if I feel to revisit the story, I'll just go watch the movies, even though the movies are not as good as the books. But yeah, I just really wanted to have a Hunger Games set in my collection again. So I went and I bought these. These are the special limit. Are they limited editions? I don't know. But they are gorgeous. Like, they're white and they have, like, really nice foily, you know, whatever, and I like them. I really, really like them. So even though I'm probably not going to read the series again anytime soon, maybe I might do a vlog where I reread the series just because I got these books. I'm happy to have another Hunger Games set back in my collection. Number 7 is a series that you started but don't plan on finishing. Several.
A lot.
But if I had to pick one series, it would probably be the Percy Jackson series. I read the first book back in 2015 and absolutely loved it. Bought the rest of the series and never read it. And when I finally, like years later, decided to reread the first book, I hated it. I didn't finish it. I read it like probably like a quarter of it and I was like, I can't do this anymore. And I just ended up getting rid of the whole series. And I regret taking so long to get back to it because I moved from a blasted camera, dumb piece of shit insect. Anyways, where were we? Yeah, I regret not reading it sooner and not finishing the series sooner because I know if I did, if I read it during that time period where my taste was aligned with what that series was offering, I would have probably enjoyed it, but I waited too long and I just kind of, I wouldn't say I outgrew it. My taste just changed and I didn't really like what the book was soothing, you know, the second time around. The last question is a new release you have no interest in reading. Y'all are going to cancel the fuck out of me when I tell you what book this is. Just to prep you, just to like, you know, prepare you, I think that this book is probably really good and if I read it, I will probably really enjoy it. I just don't have the intrinsic desire to read it. My desire to read it comes from other people talking about how amazing it is, not because I genuinely care to read it. And I doubt I'll read it like anytime soon. Don't hate me. Cemetery Boys. Like, I just think, I don't really care to read it. Like, when I hear about the premise, I'm like, sounds interesting, but I don't care to read it. The only reason why I think I might read it is because Adri loves it, Kathy loves it. A lot of my friends who read this book love it to death and would like die on the Cemetery Boys Hill. No pun intended. And so that is the only reason why I am interested in reading this book. I have no intrinsic desire to read it because it's just not really aligned with what I'm interested in right now. I'm kind of like going through a phase where I'm not really into YA these days, unfortunately. And the fantastical elements just adds another layer of to my ambivalence towards books like this. So I'm not saying I won't read it. I'm not saying I'll never read it. I'm just saying I probably won't read it anytime soon because I don't care to. You could cancel me now, it's fine. So that's it, that is my rendition of the, what do you call this again? Books I'll never read tag, TBR tag, anti-TBR tag, I don't know. That's what I had to say about that. in the comments down below, I'd love to know if you have any thoughts on any of the books that I mentioned or threw across the room today. And let me know what some of your answers to the questions might be as well. I'm very interested in having a chat about that. Please don't drag me for not liking your faves. Please don't cancel me. I love you. With all of that being said, thank you ever so much for watching this video. I hope you have a lovely, lovely day. And until next time, inshallah, keep reading.